Welcome everybody. Today we're going to talk about editing your video in the metaverse or virtual reality. I guess whichever one you want to call it. That's what we're going to do today. It all started when I had to close down my photography studio due to COVID, and I found myself working at home where I just did not have the space. Having three kids will do that to you. I had to find a solution to my workspace, and that is when I learned about the Meta Quest 2, previously known as the Oculus Quest 2. Inside the Quest 2, I learned about an app called Immersed, where I can spawn screens, resize them, put them wherever I want. I can have up to 5, and a huge bonus to all of that is I can actually work with other people and sit next to them in virtual reality and share screens and do all these very cool collaborative things. So what makes this entirely possible? Well, let me spare some of your concerns as a fellow video editor. First, latency could be as low as 3 to 8 seconds. Second, the audio does sync up very well to the video playback, and that is very important, as we all know. Three, if you're not a touch typer like myself, or I would assume a lot of us, you can actually display a virtual keyboard in front of you. Having those two elements together will allow you to pull some serious hours in this headset. See, the way this all works is your computer basically becomes a server that's just simply streaming its display into your headset. So you're not relying on the headset's computing power, you're relying on your computer's power. So depending on your computer, that's what's going to affect how you edit in VR, which should relatively be the same if you weren't in the headset. So the workflow really doesn't break. The only thing I don't really recommend using the headset for is color grading and color correction, and that's for both video and photography, unless you're really good at looking at your scopes and getting on that very scientific level when it comes to processing your clips. And even though I'll do that, I still feel more comfortable relying on a physical calibrated or the best display I have monitor to actually consider that as a finished workflow. So I guess what I'm saying is, if you're more of an AE or you're just there to string your clips together and get your effects in, this is great. But when it comes to the color correction stuff, I definitely recommend doing that outside of the headset. Just wait until the headsets get a little bit better. We have ones coming out soon with OLEDs, and they're supposed to be a lot more higher quality than the consumer level Quest 2. There will always be a learning curve. When you get this headset for the first time and you're trying this out, you will have to tinker with your screens, get them just right, but you'll get past that, trust me. If you want to make this work, it will work, and when it does, it works wonderfully. And you can really rely on it when you get it all down. Now, it's really important to know that VR is still in its infancy stages, and there is still so much for it to evolve into. However, you can really pull the hours, like I mentioned earlier, in this headset still, because while the environments and the avatars might not be realistic, you will get over that. You will get past that. I actually had a hard time getting past that at first, but I really did. And the most important thing is that your screens that are being rendered in your headset are high quality and usable, and they are. To me, as long as that works, I am happy to adjust and adapt, because I know that the new headsets will only get better, more powerful, and more realistic. There are many ways that we can work in VR, or the metaverse, and Immersed is just one of those applications. If you connect to your PC and you run the Oculus app off your computer, you can honestly bring a high quality screen into any application you want. So for example, I love playing Zenith with all my friends, but there's been a few times where I've decided to just work while in Zenith. So rather than fighting monsters and doing these quests, I can actually sit in one of the common areas where there's no monsters, but there's still people running around doing their thing, and bring my screen in and work. So technically I can make any game my work lobby and just be productive. And for me, that's one of the coolest parts about it. On top of everything, there's also augmented reality, which deserves a separate video in its own. I firmly believe in the coming years, probably sooner than we think, that people are going to start switching to these headsets and work in those, and TVs and screens are going to someday become irrelevant and obsolete because we have these high quality headsets now. Just you wait and see. Just wait. And when it happens, remember to come back and leave a comment. And before I let you go, if you like this style of content but prefer it to be short form within 60 seconds, check out my Instagram, I'll link it below. And that's where you'll find pretty much the same thing, but in a very cut and dry summarized version, just to fit it in 60 seconds. So if you're into that stuff, definitely check it out and give me a follow there. So I really hope you enjoyed this video, guys. If you did, give it a like, subscribe if you want to see more, and I'll see you in the next one. Peace.